just give you a little look at the gimbal in operation. And I can, I've got a joystick control so I can pan and tilt, turn the camera around. Various other controls, but I'm not going to go into that in this video. Hopefully it'll just give me some nice smooth footage. Well, I'm out on another bike ride. This time I'm going up to the Ridgeway. But on the way I thought I'd stop in at Hinton Parva. There's an old church there called St. Swithin's Church. And I'll spin you around and let you have a look at it. It's quite an interesting old church. Quite how old it is, I'm not sure. It is open. We'll have a look inside in a minute. Have a little walk round. Quite an unusual flat tower to it. It's not a very high tower. Every English churchyard has its yew tree, and that's what this is. These berries, flesh, red flesh, is edible, but the pip inside is poisonous. Let's have a look inside. Cycling down into Bishopston. Bishopston has got this quintessential duck pond, and the car go past. Really quite beautiful. Let's pull in and have a look at the duck pond. Bishopston's on the spring line, all these lower villages, just up on the hill, just beyond over there, there's a hill, and that's the Ridgeway path. But we're going to go around the back of the duck pond, and I'll show you an area called the city. It's rather beautiful. Let's stay over this side of the road. Thatched cottages. The city. Down there, it's not flowing very much at the moment. That's where the spring comes from, so I'm told. We're up on the Ridgeway, well, not far from it now. just cycled up to at the hill. Over to my right is Bishops and Coombs, and ahead of me now is the Ridgeway. I'm on a bit of a training mission because I want to get my legs really strong. I'm on my Diamondback mountain bike. I won't be taking my Revel up here, my Romany, my touring bike, because it's not designed for this sort of terrain. That's it, we're on the Ridgeway itself now. I'm going to cycle along here to Effington Castle. Got a plan in a few weeks to bring Aunt, my friend Aunt, along here. And we're going to, we've got a bit of a tour of the Ridgeway going on. Also, the other thing is, I hope some of you might be aware that the camera footage is a bit more, hopefully a bit more stable, should we say. So I bought myself a gimbal. I haven't been able to really justify the expense of a gimbal up until now because the prices have been so high. And this is being filmed on my GoPro Hero 4. But I bought this cheap gimbal called an iSteady. It only cost me about £80 or £90, and I wanted to test that out as well to see just how good the footage was. The road we're cycling along, it's a kind of a surfaced road, this being the Ridgeway path, but it is a bit bumpy as well, as you can see, just here especially. So hopefully the footage is coming out quite smooth. This is one of the oldest roads, apparently. In places you can drive a car along it, but mostly it's bridle way. I can spin the gimbal around, it's got a joystick control, so I can look down, I can look up, I can center it, and I can spin it round like that. It's quite nice up here. I've been doing a fair bit of cycling recently. As I said, I'm on my Diamondback at the moment, and I'm getting this bike configured for bike packing, because not only is it a convenient way to get myself into my woods for a bit of bushcraft or whatever it is I want to do in the woods, it's also a brilliant way of getting around, especially the ATB, because you can go off-road. I've bought these bags. I've got two of them on the bike now. They're called Ross Wheel, and I bought them from AliExpress. I've got the saddle bag on, and I've got the frame bag, and I've also got the handlebar bag, but I've not fitted that for this journey, so I'll insert some clips at points so you can see the bike setup. I'm fairly happy with this bike for what I intend to do with it. I think it's up to the task. I think it'll do what I want to do, a bit of a all-terrain bike packing off the trail, on the trail rather, I should say. Ahead of me, there's someone been living near Ruff for some time now. I've never actually seen them, but they've been here for ages. I saw him there. He was sunbathing himself. He looks like a man of leisure. I'm now at Wayland Smithy. I'll take you for a look inside the actual tomb itself. first time I've been able to gimbalise it. So it's nice and smooth, hopefully. It's a very good chamber. There's a funny man over there, walking round with a drum. They found ancient skeletal remains. Ancient skeletal remains in here. Well, there's the bike set up. I've got the Ross wheel frame bag and the actual saddle bag, and I'm really impressed by that. It's massive. I can get a good amount of kit in that saddle bag. And the good thing about it as well, if you've got anything which is a bit delicate, because it's kind of hanging there, it doesn't get the shocks from the ride don't get transmitted through to your equipment. I've also got the handlebar bag, but I'm not using that at the moment. I will use it at some point, but it's not as efficient or effective as these other two bags. Over there, you can just make out the on the brow of the hill up here somewhere, you can make out the back of the chalk course at Effington. I normally fly over it in the paramotor several hundred feet above that, but it's too windy to fly the paramotor at the moment. Dragon's Hill, and then we have the Vale of the White Horse stretching out into the distance, and I'm heading back that way to the low grounds. This area here is called the Manger. Over there in the distance you can see a wind farm. I should be cycling past that. Just had a little mini adventure. You see there's a sign there, it says private road. Well, I just came all the way along there. I didn't realise it was a private road. Anyway, I'm on another farm track now. This, I'm pretty sure, is a bridle way. My way lies this way, into the sun. I'm down on the low ground now anyway. Past the spring line, I'm heading on towards, it's nice down there, I'm heading on to a piece of woodland that I've got permission to put a trail camera in, so that's his extent, I think. That's better, that's why it went funny.
It's
really bumpy along here. Good test for the gimbal stabiliser. I'm going to set the trail camera up and retrieve the footage at a later date. Oh, yeah. It's really bumpy. In fact, rather beautiful as well. It's a lovely lane apart from being so bumpy. I'll let you have a look at it. You can see what I'm riding along. Just taking it steady. Because obviously, I've only got one hand on the handlebars. In fact, I think here, I've been coming off and pushing the bike. I was getting a bit bored at home. I thought, well, let's come out and have a bit of an adventure. Oftentimes, you know, it doesn't disappoint. I do enjoy the physical exercise, I must admit. As I get older, you know, I'm determined to offset the effects of aging. I'm very much aware the body's a machine, and if you don't use it, it tends to go to pot. Already, I've noticed a lot of increase in strength in my leg muscles, but part of that has always been there to a certain extent, but it's been honed a lot recently with walking the South Downs Way and then also walking Wainwright's coast to coast. And my wife and I, we took a decision back in the spring that we wouldn't use the car as much. And to be honest with you, our car, we hardly use it at all now. I went to use it the other day, when I went to drive away, the handbrake had seized on a little bit. It had jammed on momentarily because the car had been parked up for so long. Anyway, not only that, we've got the benefits of physical exercise and saving on the diesel and the fuel. And this is a good test for the gimbal. It'd be interesting to see how it works, see what it looks like, because I've not seen the footage on this yet. So I've always wanted to get stable GoPro footage, or stable footage of all sorts really. So hopefully this cheap gimbal will enable me to do that. Yeah, look at the fields now, look. The farmers are cutting some of the crop, and some of it still needs to be cut. Anyway, let's get on. Well, I couldn't cycle past without coming to say hello, mum. Comment from a chap on my last cycling video. He said you ought to get yourself some cycling clothing, you know, lycra. He says it'll make it so much better for you. I said no, that's not me, no chance. The furthest I'm ever going to go is a helmet and these glasses, and I'm only wearing these glasses for one reason: they keep the wind out of my eyes. So no, a bicycle for me is a means to get me into the woods, get me out and about, get me an adventure, and get some good distance without getting blisters on my feet. I'm really enjoying the push biking, really enjoying it. Anyway, picking my way through heavy growth here. As you can see, the woods are overgrown. Oh, I've got to find somewhere to put my trail cam. Find a nice, this looks quite interesting, this piece of ground just here. Looks like there's been a few deer passing through. I can see a trail through there. It looks very promising, this. I think I've found a nice spot to set me trail camera up. This tree's been used. I can see marks on this tree here, and I'd say that's probably a little roebuck rubbing himself on there. Probably gonna set me trail camera up on that dead stump just there.
This looks quite promising just here. Dead stuff out the way.
Well, that's the camera set now, just there. We'll leave it for a few days, come back and see what we got. So anyway, I'm heading off back home now. Time to get myself some refreshment, a bite to eat. I've only got a couple of miles to cycle. So thanks for watching this video, hope you've enjoyed it. And we'll come back on the next video and we'll see what we've managed to record on the trail cam. Bye for now.